Right now, the starting running back for the reigning Super Bowl champion Eagles, this man who fought to make the team, is now the leading Eagles rusher this season. Just ask him what he wore for Halloween. He said the purge mask.
Casual.
It's probably because he's killing these defenses out there. Please welcome to the breakfast table, Wendell Smallwood.
Good, man. Good. Thanks for having me.
Of course. No, thank you for joining us. Now, I just mentioned you went from being on the roster bubble early in training camp to where you are now, being one of the better running backs in the game. How does that motivate you when you know kind of your journey to get to where you are and now moving forward?
For me, it started right after the Super Bowl, right after that game. Mm. A lot of guys were celebrating. A lot of guys were kind of just soaking it up and partying. For me, that's what gave me a lot of motivation. Going into that year, me and LeGarrette and Sproles were huge on the offense, and then you look at the end of the year, Sproles nowhere to be found, I was nowhere to be found, and Jay and LG kind of took over, so, and Corey, of course,
yeah,
and that kind of gave me motivation, like, I want to be here, I want to be able to help these guys, not saying I didn't at all last year, but...
Right, you want
to
do more.
I wanted to do more, so... From that point on, I was like, it's on, it's time to go, it's time to work, and I was working ever since. A lot of things were being said about me, a lot of things were drawing a lot of conclusions, but I said, once I get to camp, once I get to OTAs, and once we get this season started, I'm going to show what I could do, and I've gotten an opportunity, whether it was through someone getting hurt or anything like that, and I've just been trying to take advantage of it.
You went right to work.
Absolutely.
Because a lot of people were saying that this
Super Bowl
team
hangover.
Is celebrating and Super Bowl hangover, and these guys are kicking
right
it
off.
And writing books and doing too much.
No,
you were working.
I was working from
I feel like
from
that personifies Philly just in and of itself, being an underdog, working towards that, having people not think that you're good enough. You guys are sitting here now at 4-4, the Eagles. Mm-hmm. How much harder is it to be the hunted, to be the target?
It's been extremely hard because we're not sneaking up on anyone anymore. This year, everyone knows what we're capable of, and everyone wants the best of us. They want to beat this defending Super Bowl champs, and we can play whoever, and no matter what record they have, we're going to get their 100%, and that's something we learned early in the season with these past four losses. Everyone's going to play their best game when they get to play against us, so it's been extremely hard, and I believe we're starting to adjust, and we know what we can do, we know what we're capable of, so it's just time to roll.
A lot of franchises would say, okay, we came back from that big win in London, we're 4-4, we're in the bye week, let's start our Super Bowl march. Your franchise, your general manager said, no, let's get a little better. They go out and they trade for Golden Tate. Where were you when you got that news, and how does Golden Tate add to the 2018 Eagles quest for a repeat?
I was actually visiting a local elementary school in Delaware back in my hometown when I got the Once I seen his name, I was excited, and it definitely didn't surprise me knowing how he moves and knowing how great and how better he wants this organization to become. And I know playing against him my rookie year, I only got a chance to play the Lions once, and he's just a tremendous athlete. He brings a lot of bigger plays to this offense, and I know Doug knows how to use guys. He knows how to put guys in great positions, and he's just going to be a great contribution to this offense, and I can't wait to play with him.
You know what's fun for you, too, with Golden, it's never over. After the catch, it's downfield. You get downfield, pick up a block, spring him. He's the guy, the best. He's the yak king.
Exactly. Yeah, I definitely got to see, check some more highlights.
Just to
confirm what we were getting. I was like, man, he's moving. And, you know, sometimes that's what you need out of guys when you're down, when the game's kind of up and down, and you get those big plays, and we know from there the ball can start rolling.
No doubt. Wendell, the four of us are all huge fans of the football. We all had our favorite players growing up. You're no different. You're from Delaware. You grew up an Eagles fan, and at the 2016 Combine, you ran into Eagles running back coach Deuce Staley. What was that like, man?
It was crazy. I was just sort of walking, and you know, you got this big room. They had the coaches in there, and I ran into Deuce, and it was immediately like it was almost like I was a fan. And I mean, I've been a fan, but I just ran up like a fan, and like I'm like, hey, Deuce, on Wendell. He's like, I know who you are,
bro. Yeah.
Gave him a hug, sat down and talked, and we communicated from there. I asked him for his number. I don't know if that kind of creeped him out, but I asked him for his number. And immediately after the combine, I'm like, what you think? How you think I did? And you know, a lot of people can't go and text the position coach how asking them how they did. And I just looked at him as someone that I admire, as one of my idols growing up. So being as though he took to me and kind of just ended up helping me get to Philly and being with him, it's like a dream come true every day.
It's amazing.
All right, now, speaking of that dream come true, as we're looking at this, the clips right here of that that living legend in Staley, you were the 11th running back taken in 2016. Now, there's a ton of guys that went before you, and I believe we have this list right here.
Okay.
Now, we can go down the list, and some names jump out to us. Other names were guys that had some flashes. Other names were guys we haven't quite heard from in a while. How do you use this as motivation? I went in the third round, so I know exactly what that's like.
Right. I mean, if you know how that goes, watching the draft, I probably watched the first round and then turned it off. I didn't watch second, third, fourth, and then I ended up going in the fifth. And once I got the call...
Wait. Why did you turn it off? For people at home, why did you turn it off?
It's the most stressful thing in I've ever been through. I haven't been put under so much stress watching the draft, seeing
sadness,
guys go,
anger. What's the feeling?
Sadness, anger, kind of you feel like you're not good enough. Mm-hmm. You're not. Why couldn't they pick me? I could do this better than this guy. And it's just like, I just didn't want to deal with it. Everywhere I went, every room I went to in my family's house or my cousin's
it was
house,
on.
They turning the draft on. They're like, wait, man, why you not watching the draft? Like, man, it was the most stressful thing I went through. And all it did was help me bottle up that anger and want to go out and take it on the field. And once I got the call, I didn't care. Once I stepped in the Eagles building, I didn't care when they drafted me or how high or how low they drafted me. I was like, it's time to go. I'm going to outperform this guy. I'm going to outperform that guy. And no matter where I went, once we get on the field, we're all at the same playing level. So I tell guys all the time, don't pay attention to that. Don't go somewhere thinking, oh, I'm just a free agent. I'm just a 6th, 7th round guy, because those guys are the ones that's the most hungry. And like our O-line coach says, hungry dogs run faster.
Yeah.
So that's my slogan. That's his slogan. And just took that and ran with it.
Love that. And you were taken then in the 5th round. Mm-hmm. And your rookie year, you were roommates with?
Carson.
One Carson Wentz. And I'm sure he was up late studying the playbook and getting acclimated. What were you doing?
I was asleep most of the time. I was out snoring, and I knew he tried to get to bed faster than me sometimes because he didn't want to hear me. But that guy, he was always working.
He would go to sleep early to fall asleep before you fell asleep because you had a snoring issue.
Yeah, yeah.
Is that
He definitely would try to get his Z's.
Wendell Snorwood. Yeah. Hey. That's like you see in the coverage, though, right, man? Like the holes in the coverage.
It's good. Do any three of you snore?
He's sawing wood, really.
Yeah.
I've been told that.
No snorers? You guys snore?
Breathe, right?
Yeah. Well, listen, Wendell, we appreciate you coming on.
When I watch other channels.
And appreciate you coming on, having fun with us. And I don't care if you snore. I'll tell you what, the people at home that are watching you now, they're not snoring on you anymore, man, because they're not sleeping on you.
Huge
keep doing
play
your
last
thing,
weekend,
man.
Too, man. Thank congrats you on that play.
Thanks,
that was
man.
Huge.
Appreciate it.
Keep doing your thing, man.
Thanks for having forward to what the Eagles have in store coming up, especially after that big trade. Wendell Smallwood is here in studio. We're going to take